Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today we're doing an unboxing. So I have been in love with this pattern since it came out in the early 2000s, and at the time it was way beyond my price range, so I just never got around to getting it. But with all of this year 2000s and early 90s coming out again, and me being a lover of pre-loved, I thought, you know, let's do a little eBay search. And this one came from Melbourne. Yeah, this one came from Melbourne, and it went through the eBay authentication system. Okay, not sponsored, I paid for this myself. Okay, it was originally listed for $1,500. I made an offer for $1,300. She accepted, and there was also a code that would allow me to take another $100 off that $1,300. So all in all, I paid $1,200 for this, including shipping. Okay, so I've already cut through the box there. So this is what you see. I don't think this is how it was obviously originally sent out, because it went through to the eBay authentication office first, which is here in Sydney at Lincoln. At least that's what the address on the box says, that it came from the eBay office at Lincoln. Okay, and when you open it, you've got a lot of like air tissue or air paper, whatever you want to call that. And then the bag is in an eBay dust bag, very well packaged, and more of that sort of like air paper. Right, what is in this dust bag? And it's a really nice dust bag as well, huh? Like the eBay is actually embroidered on there, it's not just like any kind of printing. But anyway, and the material is really good. But let's get into the actual bag. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the Louis Vuitton Greta. And this is the, I'm sure you guys are familiar with this. If you like Louis Vuitton, you would have seen this in the early 2000s. This is the pattern that was a collaboration with Takashi Murakami, yeah. So that is it. Let me just do a quick inspection. There is a little bit of dirt on there, but nothing substantial. Some of the, like this particular spot here has got a black dot on the fleur-de-lis. Some of the print is coming off. This particular side here has it's a little bit worse for wear on this side, but nothing that is like I wouldn't not buy it just for that. In terms of the leather, there's a little bit of dryness, but I could totally condition that. A little bit of water stains on the bottom, yeah, which is almost pretty standard for pre-loved Louis Vuitton. And for the price I paid for this, I don't think it's that bad. The strap is still really good. And actually, this is a strap that can be removed, I believe, yeah. And I incidentally have a longer strap that I bought from Mimco, which I think would pair really well with this. I told you guys that I wasn't a tote bag person, but when I saw this, I was like, game. The actual hardware is still really good. Yeah, no tarnishing at all, except for the feet at the bottom. There's a little bit of tarnishing there, but still really good. It looks like it's barely been used, apart from like the watermark, water stains, and the zip has got, yeah, a little bit of tarnishing on the actual zipper. Let's listen to the zipper. Ah, that's smooth, man. Let's do that again. Yeah, no problems with that. There's a bit of scratches on the strap. That's absolutely fine. There, what's inside? So inside is red suede. Okay, and it actually came with its original dust bag. Perfect. This is, let me just find the tag. So inside is, there's like one large zip pocket and then another smaller one here that is meant to be for cell phones, because back in the early 2000s, you have to have a pocket for your cell phone. I mean, if you remember how chunky the phones were back in the day. And let me just find out what's the serial number on this guy. All right, I actually had to go and do that for me to look for the date code, and I honestly can't find it. There is a very faint marking around here that looks to me like it was there, but the problem with this interiors of Louis Vuitton is because it's suede or suede-like material, they have a tendency to rub off, and yeah, it just looks like it disappeared. Okay, there's a faint mark there. I can barely see what it is. It looks like an R. I'm not even gonna try. But anyway, it came from the eBay authentication, I suppose, office here at Lincoln. And it actually also has this tag that says return void if removed. And then inside this little envelope here, I'm gonna open that up. Let me just put this back together. All right, there we go. In that little envelope is, now I know Kenny has just done an unboxing from them as well, an eBay purchase. So this one has, here's to your new bag, congratulations on your purchase. We're thrilled to deliver this beautiful handbag along with proof that it's the real deal. Your new edition has been meticulously authenticated so you can carry it with total confidence. Thanks for choosing eBay Authenticity Guarantee. And then it comes with a guarantee card. So authenticity guarantee, tap card to your NFC enabled phone to view your authentication details. That's pretty cool. And I know Kenny said that his doesn't really have a lot of details, but mine says Louis Vuitton Greta. So it actually tells you which bag it's for. So I'm actually gonna try and see if I can do that NFC card thing. Right, so I've tapped it. And it opened it in Chrome, or it's asked me to open it in Chrome. Okay, well, it's a little bit of a wait, but my internet's slow, so that's why. There you go. Oh, wow. Okay. So what does it actually say? Louis Vuitton Greta hobo bag, authentication ID, nothing on that page. Let's click on about this item. Ah, and it comes up with that. How cool. Wow. Okay. Well, there you go. That's what you actually see. Fantastic. I just hope that, well, I'm supposed they also couldn't find the serial date or the date code themselves. I tried. There is some faint markings on there, but I just can't decipher it. So, but still, it's pretty cool that, yeah, that you can actually see all of that information on there. And at least it's guaranteed by eBay. So I guess that's a good thing. Well, yeah, that's my unboxing for you guys. I really, really like this. I've been in love with it since the 2000s. I remember seeing this in the fake market in the Philippines because it was just so popular at that time. Never did I imagine back then that I would be an owner of an actual Murakami. So yeah, that's fantastic. Even if, you know, I said to you guys, I don't really like tote bags or bags that are this size, but I would carry this, I would rock this. And even if I don't, I'm just gonna put it on display. Like, I love it. I love it. I love it. I was thinking, should I just get an SLG that is this pattern? But I was like, nah, I need a bag. So when I saw this, I just grabbed it. 20 years in the making. Right. Well, thank you so much, guys, for watching this unboxing and watch my excitement over such a beautiful bag. And yeah, I think that's it for today. I will definitely do a review of this bag once I've had enough time to use it. But I love it. I am absolutely in love with it. Oh, before you go, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that notification bell so that you know when I upload videos and you don't miss out.